Did you hear what I said? Stop using your past to disqualify your future. Hallelujah. Because what you don't understand is God's going to use your past to justify your future. Because the shift in the kingdom of God is that God's going to begin to use people that have been through some things. Oh yeah, you have a questionable past. Your reputation has been marred because God suffered you to get into some things. But God's going to use you to testify to the nation that this is what it was, but this is what it is now. And if it had not been for God, God's going to take your brokenness. Can somebody tell him he's great? Look at somebody and tell him he's great. Look at somebody and tell them he is great. Ooh. Look at somebody and tell them you don't have a reason to be sad because he's great. Oh, I wish I could get some help. Look at somebody and tell them he's a mighty God. He's a mighty God. He's a mighty. Woo! I just wish you just grab somebody by the hand and tell them we ain't got nothing to worry about. Because the Lord we serve is a great God. Tell them the Lord we serve is a great God. Tell them the Lord we serve is a great God. Tell them, I don't care what you're dealing with. Tell them, my God is a champion. Woo! He's undefeated. And his record won't be broken. Tell somebody, neighbor, your God is a champion. He's undefeated. And his record won't be broken. You ought to look at somebody and start prophesying to them. Say, I believe that things are about to change for you. I believe that things are about to shift for you. No, but you got to step out to where you are. You got to step out of frustration. You got to step out of anger. You got to step out of bitterness. You got to step out. Tell a neighbor, if you don't step out, I'ma pull you out. If you don't come out, I'ma snatch you out. Because God's been too good for you to look like that. God's been too good for you to be bound. God's been too good for you to feel like that. I'm not gonna let you go till we both get a blessing. If you don't come out, I'm gonna snatch you out because I am anointed to survive. And if you gonna be my friend, then you gonna have to be delivered to. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Don't get on the organ. You supposed to wait until he got there, Chris.
In him there is no failure. In him there is no failure. Oh, in him there is no failure. He is Christ, Christ the Lord I shall forever praise him. I shall forever praise him. I shall forever praise him. He is Christ the Lord. There is no one above him. Oh, there is no one above him. There is no one above him. He is Christ the Lord. Oh, I will forever love him. I will forever love him. I will forever love him. His name is Christ the Lord. I remember the saints in the old church would be saying stuff like, have your way, have your way. I'm a young man, but a lot of old people living in me. Look at your neighbor and tell me, we're going to let the Lord have his way. It ought to make you feel good to hear some old person in church. Oh, have your way. Have your way. Y'all remember that? Y'all remember the old, have your way. And that's what we want the Lord to do. We want him to have his way. Because I know some of y'all got some situations that you ain't going to testify about. You got some situations you can't tell nobody about. But isn't it good news to know that even the things that you don't talk about, God already knows about. Have your way. Hey, y'all don't have a visual left. You see the mother sitting on the front pew and they ain't running and jumping because they don't have that kind of energy. But they be sitting there rocking, going back and forth. Have your way. And that's the reason, y'all, we got a breakthrough because the mothers was praying. Have your way. Because we was ready to sing, we was ready for the music, we was ready to dance, but somebody in the church was saying, have your way. I wish I could get two or three people that would agree with me. And just tell the Lord, have your way. 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 Because the saints were singing, Evangelist Butler, when the saints begin to pray and let the Lord have his way, the glory of the Lord, the glory, the glory. I wouldn't trade this kind of church for nothing in the world. I don't go to church for programs and people and preachers. I go to church because I need a visitation with the Lord. You ought to look at somebody and tell them, I need a visitation with the Lord. Tell them, if you only knew what I had to go through to get here. Only God makes this trip worth the while. Only God makes the gas worth paying for. Only God makes getting up early in the morning worth it. If I couldn't see God, I'd rather stay at home. But you want to give somebody a high five and say, neighbor, I sure do thank him because he showed up. I sure do thank him because he showed up. I've had my times to go to church and know God. We can have a lot of singing and know God. A lot of preaching and know God. A lot of dancing and know God. But tell your neighbor, I give it all up. If I can see God, if I can see God, he'll change me. If I can see God, he'll transform me. Yeah! Oh.